Today's my treat. Phantom Thieves are all about fancy stuff like this, right? That's why we're here. Oh, and it's just the two of us, so don't be afraid to go all out. What do you want to eat? Steak
sounds good.
Doesn't it? Meat's perfect for tough guys like us. By the way, this place is all you can eat, so let's make sure we get our money worth.
Actually...
Anyway, I posted on the fan site that I had connections to you guys. The fandom really ate that up. Huh? Don't worry though, I didn't say anything that would point to my real identity. I did end up talking about how expensive it is to run our little organization though. The donations I got after that were pretty generous to say the least.
What?
Our loving sponsors just wanted to show some support. Not bad for strategic management, huh? You're amazing. That was a piece of cake for someone as good as me. Let's take advantage of this windfall as much as we can. Oh, and it's okay to consider this meal as an organizational expense, right?
Sure.
Wait a minute. I've seen on the news that using donations for stuff other than what's publicized is a serious crime. Food is definitely an acceptable business expense, but can the same be said of an expensive buffet?
Oh.
The more I think about this whole thing, the less I think we should use the donations here. I mean, people would get mad at a politician for using tax money for personal affairs. The same probably applies to phantom fees. I guess returning the money would be the best choice. Of course.
That's right.
We really need to make sure we keep the image of the Phantom Thieves clean in our fans' minds. I think I'll return the money and thank the fandom for their generosity. They'll love that. It might be a waste of some nice resources, but it's all good as long as it boosts our popularity, right? Man, maybe I was born into the strategy stuff. I'm honestly getting pretty good at it. Don't worry, I'm still gathering info on the forum, too. I actually have a few solid leads right now. Everything so far has been close to home. These next ones are gonna pull your socks off.
Alright. Oh.
So, if we're gonna return the money, how are we gonna cover the meal? I'm flat broke. I guess let's just go home. Shame. Shame. Search for truth, ask your own questions, and then find your own answers. This philosophy, I'm not sure if I like this writer. He seems a bit condescending.
What are your thoughts?
So you finished reading Wise Men's Words. I wonder if this old philosopher's had many friends. They're always talking to people, but I don't know. Anyway, reading about different ways of thinking was the major story. Yep. Really?
All right.
Man. Oh, we're almost at the station.
The rumors are pretty terrible.
Male stuff is insane. I didn't think it had anything to do with me, but there are even victims in my class. Oh, I know all about that. These guys supposedly come asking if you want an easy, high-paying job. But then if you say yes, you get dragged into some real shady stuff. Teachers, a student council pres will do something about it, though. People are real worried. Oh, are you talking about that posting? I wonder if she made it serious about it. I heard she knew about Kamoshida and sexual harassment. She probably won't be too much help. She wants us to do all the work. That Ida guy's here. Try and ask him about it. Good luck. Leave it to me. That level of motivation actually makes me a little more nervous. In any case, let us know if you learned anything.
Hey!
Nijima-kun, what is going on here? Apparently the damage done by this so-called mafia has even reached our student body.
Well,
I thought this absurdity was nothing but a joke. Not only are the victims there, or even rumors that some are involved in such crimes.
I messed that up, I'm sorry.
I've even received inquiries from their guardians. Why is this happening? Unfortunately, I do not have the answer to that. This is the greatest disgrace in the history of this academy, if it were to be discovered. This is a vital issue for the student council. Did I not ask you to resolve it? Doing the best I can. And I can trust you? You must do something about this at once! You're the only one who is reliable around here. Don't let me down! From what I've heard, even though the students are starting to be dissatisfied with you. At this rate, you and I will both lose our scrolls at this school. Do you understand? I do. Please just give me a little more time.
Wow. Oh, humpty dumpty. I feel sorry for her, but like...
How tragic.
She just...
Before I realized it, we're halfway through June. Oh my. It's the only month of the year with no holidays, and it's filled with a rain. Truly a season of hell. I'm exaggerating, you say? Oh my. You're all just ignorant. Ignorant swine, all of you. After all, what's falling from the sky is acid rain that can melt metal. Genryuji-kun, let's test your knowledge and imagination. Huh?
Give it a try.
What would happen if you keep washing your hair with water that's contaminated with metal?
It'll change color.
That's right. By the way, your hair will turn green if the metal is copper or red if it's rust. However, acid rain can't melt gold or silver. If you want to dye your hair gold, use bronze coins. Indeed. Thinking you can save money by skipping a visit to the hair salon? It seems you still don't understand the horror of acid rain.
No way. Oh, yes, you knew that?
Nice going!
All right.
London once had acid rain on the level of stomach acid. More than 4,000 people died. Oh my! Perhaps one day such a deathly rain will fall on Japan. My heart too is overcast, just like the rain that falls on the city. Oh rain, go away. Come again some other day.
I'm tired of thinking of everybody's comments.
Hey,
I see Lady Anne's going to talk to you there. You're gonna back her up, right?
Sorry for asking you so suddenly.
I really need some money right now. Can you tell me about this easy part-time job? I'm sure you know about it, Ida-kun. Please? You don't need my help. A girl like you could probably get a job anywhere, right?
Huh?
Now that you mention it, yes. What I mean is... Fast. Oh, Francois.
Huh? Hey, wait!
Hey, what are you... My cat Francois got run over by a car and also has an incurable illness. I need money today. Oh my god. If Francois were to die, I think I'd die too, probably. Come on, don't talk like that.
You don't mind, do you?
Like it, then tell me about that easy part-time job. You know something, don't you? I've heard the rumors.
Rumors? Was it Ishiyama who...
Huh?
Ishiyama? Hey, what was that about Ishiyama? That's
incredible.
She got the momentum back. She's not acting anymore now, is she? Come on, let's leave this guy to Han and go look for that Ishiyama fella.
Hey,
you have a minute? You're looking for something, right? I want to help you out, so please ask me anything.
Where's
Ishiyama? Ishiyama? He usually hangs out with Ida. Oh, so you want to ask him about Ida? So that's why Takamaki Hosan was chasing
him. Sorry.
Sorry, I don't know where he is right now. He usually stays till late, so I think he's probably still somewhere in the school.
Oh.
I'll keep digging around what you're looking for. Guess you can let him handle this. I'll have to ask someone else about Nishiyama's whereabouts. Can you think of anyone who might know?
No.
That's interesting.
How much you want to bet he's at the school gate? He's outside the school gate. I bet you. I bet my left ball sack, boy. Wait. Okay. The school gate's not. I like how all these dudes have no faces, like no eyes or whatever. That's kind of creepy. Library at school. The library's just up on the floor above this one. Why should I talk to him? Thank you.
I can't do this.
Oh, no way.
Nishiyama? Yeah, that's me. You're that transfer student, right? Need something? What's this about a job? Job?
I don't know. Are you talking about that one time? I don't know. I said I didn't want to do it. It's something, Ida. Wait. Are you doing something to him? He's been acting really strange lately. Tell me what I want to know. Fine, I'll do what you say. Just please don't hurt me. Tell me what you know. One day the two of us went to Shibuya and a man approached us over near Central Street. He asked if we were interested in an easy part-time job. I said I wasn't, but Ida was into it. He was asking the guy all sorts of questions. What was his job? I don't know. I was so scared, I ended up going home. But according to Ida, it only took 10 minutes and is good for people who don't stand out. What happened after that? Ida started spending a lot of money. That's when his strange behavior began, too. But that's all I know. That's enough, right?
How suspicious.
It is suspicious. Maybe he was making him commit crimes? Have you found out anything more, Korea? I've tried looking into this high-paying part-time job myself. People seem to be talking about it here as well. Supposedly, a man will talk to you in broad daylight around Central Street. Your job is to deliver a small envelope, can't you? I will contact you again if I learn anything. So that means this part-time job is somehow real crime-related. It takes 10 minutes, it's good for people who don't stand out, and involves...
Well?
Is there any bells? Something the Mafia would definitely be up to.
Drugs.
Like illegal drugs? Maybe they made either smuggle drugs for them. That definitely fits with the small envelope. You can get arrested for just for possession. Did you meet Nishiyama? I looked into Ida on my own anyway. Rumor has it he got involved in some kind of suspicious part-time job. And that job's apparently totally insane. Something about trafficking drugs, I think. I hear they ask you to take part in it down on Central Street in broad daylight even.
For real?
So he is smuggling. This won't be pretty. Come on, let's go back to Lady On. We'll ask Ida directly.
Don't wander around.